Hi everyone, it's Andy from Hobby Headquarters. Well, I've got an exciting new build for you guys today, and something, as you can see just by the box art, something a little bit different than what we normally build, or actually that any manufacturers even produced. This is a 1/72 scale Yamato turret off of the battleship Yamato, which was the heaviest and most powerfully armed battleship in World War II. Had 46 centimeters or 18 inch guns on it, 9 of them, and it was just a beast of a armament package, shall we say. And TACOM has come up in 72nd scale, so it's pretty large, with one of the turrets off of here. They give you a little section of deck as well as the turret to build up, and makes a beautiful desktop piece, you know, to show off. And this is something I think they're going to see more, that we're going to see more and more of, because I know they're also going to be doing a Bismarck very soon too, and maybe a whole bunch of other things. So something a little bit different. And if they ever decide they want to make the entire ship, I guess it would only be in 72nd scale, about 11 feet long. I figured it out a while ago, 10 or 11 feet long, but something massive. But what an incredible thing that would be. But I don't think we're going to see that anytime soon. But it's a great kit. Not a lot of parts, but there is a lot of little details, like doing the railings and some of the other things like that. So it's going to take us a little bit of time on it, but excited to start it. So let's get started. Okay, so we're going to start off building our Yamato turret with the 18-inch guns by first working on the deck. Now, there is not a heck of a lot to do on this portion of it because we want to paint this separately from the gun, because this is going to be a wooden deck color and we'll be able to weather the wooden boards and things like that. The only piece that we needs to be put on right now, because we have two hatches we have to put on, those are going to both get painted the gray color that the ship is painted, but we do have to put these little plates on here, and they go along the inside lip of the turret ring here. Problem is, I'm looking at the instructions and they're not really showing exactly where they're supposed to go, and there's no little pin or indicator marks to do it too. So there's 10 total on it, so I probably will just divide up, you know, the circle and go ahead and put them in based on where I think they're going to go on there. Pretty simple, as you can see right here, flat bottom to it. So that shouldn't be too difficult. But we're going to put that aside for right now, because that really is the only thing we need to do before we actually start painting. What we're going to do now is we're going to start working on the actual inside of the turret, and I'll kind of show you how these are going to work. So we've got the two halves of the inside of the barrel. You can see those are going to get glued together just like that, and I've got this one already glued together here. No use sanding or anything inside. It's all going to be hidden inside the turret. Mount those inside just like that, and then we can go ahead and put these locking mechanisms on here too, and we'll glue those into place. That's going to hold all three of those in place. We can also go ahead and glue in the back here. Once again, not getting seen inside. This is more or less the bracing inside for, I believe they're the range finders on this. So this gets put glued together, and these will be able to rotate inside here just like that. And then there'll be two rods that come out of the side here, but that's once we actually put the top of the turret on. And so what I'm going to do now is we're going to get these all glued up, these braces right here glued into place. Also, one other thing I should point out too, these little push pin marks are kind of big on the inside here. And normally you wouldn't have to worry about taking them off, but the two right here and then the two on the other side, actually it's on the... show you on this. I was doing some dry fitting. These need to, you don't have to sand them down or anything, just knock the tip off, or you won't be able to get them to fit flush. Just before, you know, just keep that in mind. Then for on this side of the turret, the only thing we have to do now is go ahead and glue, actually flip this over and glue this inside just like that. So not a heck of a lot to do right here, but I'm going to get all of this glued into place, and then I will show you how everything starts to fit together. Okay, we've got these three glued into place here. You also want to be very, very careful not to glue them in any position. So we want to keep the glue just on the pegs, not on those pieces. And this thing is supposed to rotate. I don't ever plan on moving those inside the rangefinders inside, so I've just glued that permanently into position there. So now we are going to take our Tamiya orange glue, because this is a much bigger surface area that we don't want to have it dry instantly. And I don't want this piece popping off, so. And a little extra glue right around the inside seam. Like I said, don't want this stuff popping off later on once we've glued it all together. So we'll let that set up for a few minutes. But once we do that, we'll be able to go in. Actually, this should probably be okay. Pop those up into place like that. And then we drop the turret into place. And then we'll go ahead and just put glue all around the inside seam here. And get this all glued together just like that. And then as soon as that dries, I will show you how these side pieces go on. Next up, we are going to attach inside here these pieces just like that. And now I've built up one side of this here, and it's pretty easy. There's actually only three little pieces that make up these little side units, and they will literally slide that in there and then come at it at an angle, and it'll snap right into place. So we've got one on this side and one on the other side, and then we will go ahead and attach those and glue them into place just like that. And you can see how quickly it's starting to come together. Here we are. We've got both of these side units attached here. And I did want to point out to you, I did have to go ahead and put a tiny touch of filler putty on the inside here. It was very, very minor amount, but it was just enough that it was kind of a little bit of light bleed through, so I thought we'd take care of that now. Now, I've also gone ahead and just placed it on top of the base here. It will pop out just like a regular turret off of a 35th scale tank with that piece there. But I popped it in here to basically protect some of the parts as we start to put them on. So you can see here on the back, I've gone ahead and attached this ladder, this rear port, as well as the entry hatch and this little step platform here that we had to bend up a piece of photo etch for that. Now I want to show you, actually I'll flip this around to show you where the piece goes, but TACOM has also included a couple of these, and these are going to get super glued right underneath this barrel and this barrel, not the center barrel, just the outside barrel. And the photo etch, you're going to definitely need some kind of bending tool. Now I'm using the Tamiya big flat bender, and there is a little bit of a seam here, but you can't bend it very straight without the actual bender. In fact, it wants to bend on the holes and not on that little seam right there. So with this tool, you'll be able to line that up perfectly straight, and then with either, you know, like a razor blade or a piece of glass, kind of bend it into shape, and then you get a nice perfectly bent piece just like that. So keep that in mind. I tried to do it on the other one without the bender, just testing it, and yeah, it did not work. It wanted to bend in the wrong spot. Now we can move that out of the way, and we're going to start working on the barrels. And I literally have just cut these off just a few minutes ago. You can see we have some cleanup on the top and in the middle here. And my recommendation is too, when you go ahead to sand these, do not sand them this way. Sand them up and down to get that little piece off. That way you're gonna, if you sand them side to side, you have, sometimes you could leave a little bit of an opening, and when you glue them together, you could have a little bit of a gap that you're gonna have to fill later on. Whereas if you're sanding from top to bottom like that, you'll be sanding the whole thing flush and you shouldn't have that problem. Now, they're gonna go together pretty simply. It's an A and B side. They're gonna snap together just like that, and then you will build up the blast bags. Now, I've started to build two of these up here, and these are in different stages. This one is almost complete here. We've got the blast bag. There is a long seam down the middle of the blast bag that I've sanded and filled, put a couple of coats of sealing Mr. Surfacer 15 or 1200, excuse me, on this one right here. And I think we've got it to a really good point where it's ready almost to attach to the thing. I'm gonna do a little, maybe slight touch up. This one is almost as far along. I just glued the tip on here, which has a little bit of the rifling for the barrel. So you can see that's why it's a different color plastic. And there's just a little bit more touch up we need to do up around in here. And that's because they are very small little pieces here, so we had to get some fine sanding sticks and just go back and forth and making sure we don't leave any flat spot on the actual barrel. But it probably took a grand total of about 20 minutes to get it to this position right here. So we literally have just one more complete barrel we have to do. I'm going to go ahead and work on that one for the next, 20, 30 minutes, get it going there, and then we can start attaching the rest of the ladders on the side here, and then also the handrail that goes across the top. And before we attach these, we do want to paint them, because these blast bags are going to get painted a different color, and I've got a couple of ideas about painting those, but we'll do that when we actually get to the paint portion. Next up, we get to put in all of the little accessory pieces on the top of the turret, including these little lines that are going to get glued in. Very, very fragile. We do have to do a little bit more sanding on it. Got to be very careful as we do that. And then this one will come right on the other side here and basically follow the edge of that going down. And then this piece will cover over that. We also get to put on the ladders at this point, both in the front on the other side, and actually this is the front one right here. It's a big long one that'll cover up in the front there. Then after we get all of those parts glued on, we have the railing to cut out, which are these little pieces all through in here, and you can see they all have the hollowed out little hole already, and that is because they give you some monofilament that we'll be able to weave through. So obviously when we go to do this, it's very, very important that we keep the holes going in the right direction for each one of the rails. You can see the holes drilled in here. So we just got to make sure that the railing is going to follow that exactly, so we're not having any weird, oh, the string's coming in from the side, rather it's supposed to be coming in from the front type thing. So I'm going to get all of these ladders glued on, get those out of the way, and then I'm going to cut off all those little the parts of the railing, and then we'll start to glue those in place, and we're going to show you that right now. As you can see right here, I've started to put a couple of the parts of the railing into place here. And I realized I needed to go ahead, and there's some micro railing right here. And I guess it was for if you were accidentally on the ship and you slid, you'd have something to grab onto so you didn't slide off the turret if you slid underneath the main railing. And the parts came in photo etch, as you can see right here. And when I was removing the tape that goes on here, I pulled some of those off and damaged them quite badly, not realizing as I'm pulling the tape that I had pulled those completely and messed them up. So what I'm doing right now is I've gone ahead and taken some really tiny wire, hopefully you can see it right there, and I'm bending some basic shapes to fill in the areas that I messed up. So like we'll drop some of these railings right into place here. You can see I've already put four of them in here. They're not going to have the rods going down, and the rods going down, as you can see in here, are pretty tiny to begin with. So it's going to have to do basically for what we're doing right here. It'll be better than having nothing. I think once we put paint on it as well, I don't think you'll even notice the difference. Okay, what I'm doing right now is we're threading up all of rope or wire railings that go around the turret here. And not super, super easy as I thought it was going to be. I don't think we're going to be able to get a sag at all on them in there. But one thing I did find that made it a little bit easier is to thread one long continuous piece around. Now, when you get to this portion right here, there's supposed to be railings going this way. And that'll be fine. We're going to super glue all that into place. And then taking our Tamiya super sharp cutters, we can get in here and cut those out and then put the other railings that go in here. So I just ran one whole one around here, and it was a lot easier than trying to do the smaller pieces. Also, you got to be careful not to knock off any of your railings, which I've done twice, these little railings right here, just because you're trying to get around all of that stuff. So I'm going to thread all this on right now, get them all glued up, and then we can start putting our paint job on here. And with that, I think that's going to make them look a lot better. Next up, we're taking a little bit of dark sea gray and lightly filling in some of the middles of these panels. It's just a little bit lighter color and should give us a nice faded effect. Gone ahead and gloss coated the entire model just with a very, very subtle amount of gloss coat. And that is so when we do our weathering, it'll flow a lot easier on the paint. I've also gone ahead and painted the blast bags on the guns. And you can see here, they're a deck tan color. So that I looking at the other paints, I thought this is actually a really nice looking faded canvas color. And I think it'll go really well inside here. So we're going to go ahead and start doing just a little bit of weathering. I don't want to put too much on it here because these ships are kept up when they're at sea just because they don't get all rusty and stuff like that. So we'll just put a little bit of panel liner on it here and there just to make some of the things pop out. And I'll show you that right now. Right now we're just applying a very, very thin down wash into all of these areas that we want to make pop out a little bit. We don't want to do a lot of weathering. At least I don't want to do a lot of weathering on this because upkeep did happen on ships and even in World War II. And there was always, if a guy can touch it, a guy can paint it. So we're not going to see any of the rust or anything like that on, at least I don't believe so. And what we want to do now is just, like I said, make a few of these little areas pop out just so it doesn't look so flat. And we're just using a little black panel liner for that. Any areas that have any bolts. And then cotton swab to go in any areas and remove any excess that we don't want around there. Okay, now that we've sprayed the entire deck with that light deck tan color, we're just using some brown panel liner from Tamiya and with a wider brush so it doesn't take forever. Going with the pattern of the grain of the actual wood slats. We don't want weird grain patterns showing up on it. And just start dragging it back and forth. And because if you do it this way, you can start to see certain boards will get darker and lighter than other ones. So we should get a nice random pattern on this. And it's just a matter of just keep going back and forth over it and blending it till you get it to the way you want it to be. And we're going to repaint these areas right in here with the gray. But obviously there's a lot to do on this particular one because it's a pretty good sized deck. So I'm going to go ahead, start working on this a little bit more, blending and blending and blending all over the top here. And then we'll let it dry and we'll come back and show you what it looks like. And now that we've let it set up for a little while, we're just going to take a paper towel and kind of randomly just go down and start streaking with the pattern of the grain to kind of get a little bit more variation in here to remove some of the excess. And now that we've let the initial wash dry completely over the whole deck, we're just picking out some individual boards with the panel line and just carefully highlighting that little board just to give it a little bit of contrast. You can see how these are starting to pop out in the frame, that it just doesn't make it look like it's all monotone or one continuous color over the entire thing. And just every once in a while, like I said, just pick out a different board, do the whole length of it, and then as they dry, they lighten a little bit less than that, but they still stick out to the eye. So we're going to do a couple more of those throughout the entire deck, and then we can go ahead and start masking all of this to paint this gray. Taking a little piece of paper and kind of made a simple mask to keep the overspray from landing on all the work we just did on the deck. And with that, we are now going to paint the ring IJN Gray, the Kiri Arsenal XF75 from Tamiya that we've already thinned down. And now we'll just go and rotate the mask as we go around and paint up all the areas that we got a little bit of the brown on. And after that is done, we're just taking a real fine Tamiya brush here and just filling in any of the areas by hand that we missed. Now, most of this is going to get covered by the turret, but we still want to have a nice looking ring going all the way around. And once we let this dry and put a coat of clear coat over it, it'll blend in with the rest of the paint. And here we are. Here is our completed model. And I'll just go over just a couple of little minor things that we did off camera, just some little weathering effects. One thing I did was obviously we attached the barrels with a little super glue. Going forward, you really don't have to attach those inner portions of the barrel that were on that swing arm, because none of these can swing at all anyway. And honestly, it may have even been a little bit easier attaching these just with a little super glue in place there. Just something to think about. You might still want to put yours in place there. I just found it to be a little cumbersome to try to push those in there. Now, I've also gone ahead and taken a little bit of the deck tan, a 50-50 mix with that and white, and then dry brushed over all of the canvas areas and added a little bit of a brown wash into the creases, just to give it a little bit of texture and depth to it so it doesn't look like it's a plastic piece. And then, of course, we went and painted the entire model with TS-80, Tamiya's flat coat, which is this stuff right here. And it gives it a nice blend. We did have the gloss over it, so it's not 100% dead flat. It's kind of got just a touch of sheen to it, as I would imagine that a ship would actually have. Now, as you saw, the kit went together really well. It was a little difficult putting in the railings throughout the top there, but you can see once we figured out and threading them through, worked fine on it there. And then, of course, we did replace all of those little slide railings with a a soft brass, a wire that we could bend into shape there and put those on, which I think actually turned out pretty good. I think they look really good on there.
And we'll also give you a little overhead view of the turret as well. The turret will be available very, very soon in the United States, and you'll be able to order it on our website, andyshhq.com. And like I said, overall, it was a great. It's great to mix it up as a modeler rather than building the same stuff over and over again. And this is just really different and unusual. Those big 18-inch guns and this big deck platform that it comes with is going to make a great, great desk piece, especially when we put it on the counter in my store here. Also, keep in mind, too, TACOM is coming out with a Bismarck B turret, which is the second turret in, which comes on the elevation part of the deck, so you'll get a little bit higher up view type turret. And I mean, I would think that they would eventually do the Iowa class 16 inch guns as well, so something to look forward to. So I want to take this opportunity to thank you guys as always for watching, and please stay tuned because we have many more videos coming. And if you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button down below. And if you like this video, give us a thumbs up. I'd appreciate it.